All right, it is that time again, Watercooler Wednesday. We are taking a look at some of this week's hot topics.
And this morning we are joined by some very familiar faces. Kevin Cerrito from Sports 56 and CerritoTrivia.com. Welcome back, my friend. Our own Corie Ventura and Todd Demers. You
good
wonder
to see
why
you.
Kevin has been missing from Watercooler Wednesday for a couple of months.
We got the proof. We have the reason right here in this picture, if we can take it just for a second
here. He's been busy not sleeping, right? This precious baby is.
That is Mila. That is my daughter, Mila. She's almost 2 months.
First time father.
Mm-hmm. How
are
you feeling?
Need no sleep.
I'm feeling tired. I was up until Todd went on the air this morning with Corie. So.
Is trivia going to change? Like now, you're not going to do Friends Night. You're going to do like baby Tycho Night or, you know.
I like that because all the parents will know exactly what's going on.
We already do a lot of Disney trivia. So.
Yeah, now you'll know the answers.
Right.
The perfect
all right.
fit.
All Congratulations.
Right.
Thank you.
Well, nearly half of all Americans are finding extra work outside their full-time jobs. But a surprise motivation behind those side hustles. One expert says while most people want a little extra income, that's the reason, that is actually not their top priority. Turns out, according to one survey, it's about having fun and doing something that brings you joy. Financial experts say side hustles are different from second jobs. Those kinds of jobs are necessary to pay things like rent or buy groceries. But business analysts warn, keep your day job, because if the side hustle doesn't work out, you still have a main source of income. Plus, you might have health insurance. So, Kevin, you are like the king of, you made your side hustle the main hustle.
I first heard the word side hustle from him.
Really?
That's
really?
Right. I think he may have coined that term.
I don't know if I coined the term, but.
Well, we give you credit.
I do think a lot of the people who host trivia and stuff for me, because I've got 11 events a week, I'm not at everything. And other people, their side hustle is to do Cerrito Trivia, Cerrito Bingo, be the host.
Oh, yeah.
And I do think it's something they enjoy, right? It's a way to channel their creative outlet, give them a chance to perform in front of a crowd. So I do believe in this, but I do think, I mean, it's always that what would you do if you won the lottery? I mean, not everybody, you know, you're going to quit your job probably. Mm-hmm. So, like, a little bit is out of necessity. You need that extra money.
Yeah.
I don't necessarily believe that people are doing side hustles just for fun.
Because I wonder if you have a craft that you turn into a money maker, even a little one, does it ruin the joy once you start making, you know, then it becomes something you have to do.
Because, Corie, you're like the queen of side hustles out there. You are out there. You are out there taking care of business.
Yeah, but I made it work because I love sports.
Right.
And I like to be around sports. And therefore, I made that part of my side hustle.
You should explain what your side hustle is.
Memphis
it's involved with the Grizzlies.
And the Nashville Predators.
Yeah.
And so that's something that I love to do and I love to be a part of and to be next to. Mm-hmm. And so I just made sure that I was a part of that in any way possible. And it just worked out.
Do you see more people doing this?
Oh, absolutely. Everyone's always like, hey, how can I?
Right.
It is so much fun. It's lucrative as well. So it's kind of the best of both worlds.
Mm. But you don't get a lot of sleep because
Team
of
no
your
sleep.
Hours.
Right. And I don't have a newborn.
That's it. Todd, can you get the side hustle on your schedule?
Probably not. But I see how it's for a lot of people, like things like, is it Pinterest? Pinterest where people do some crafts and things. I think whatever that side hustle is, as you were mentioning earlier, it has more to do with something utilizing your creativity, something you can do in your own time. And I think it's something that's more satisfying for you to be able to help others with something along those lines.
Getting your side hustle on.
You could be paid for like a sleep study or something. That would be ideal for you.
All right, we'll keep it moving here. A mother goes viral after she noticed her son had a new collection of hair scrunchies. She questioned him about them and discovered they are a new cultural trend among middle schoolers. Apparently, a girl gives them to a boy she likes and he wears them on his wrist. The mom joked her son had received so many, she's starting a lost and found collection. So, Corie, what do you think about this?
How did you approach your crush in middle school?
Well, I mean, I think I just sent him like a little note or something. We didn't have, they were in our cell phones. Come on, no cell phones. I couldn't tweet anything, couldn't do anything, you know? So I think I just did like a little note and it was like, or walked and said, hey, can you sign my yearbook? You know, something like that.
How did it work for you?
I mean, not made for television, I guess. I don't know.
Obviously worked for you.
We got a lot to talk about after the show.
Well, when Henry starts coming home with scrunchies, we're going to at least know what's going on. I seem to remember class rings. You'd exchange class rings of some kind. Or, you know, your girl would wear your ring or she'd wear it on a string around your neck or something like that. That's how far back I go, okay? So that's what I'm
saying. You're telling us no cell phone.
No selfies, nothing like that. Here's my ring.
You don't have class rings in middle school, but also, are you walking around with the yearbook like in September and October?
No, because I wait all year round and I go to that specific person and then I ask them because I like totally plan everything out.
Well, anyway, I'm glad the story is out now, so I can go ahead and put trackers on my daughter's scrunchies.
Yeah, there you go. Who knows?
GPS devices.
Ellen DeGeneres is defending herself against backlash of all things after she sat next to former President George W. Bush, the W there. The daytime talk show host was sitting next to the former president at the Dallas game. The internet exploded with both good and bad reactions. On Tuesday, she addressed the criticism, saying she was invited by Jerry Jones' daughter. He's the owner, of course, of the Cowboys. And is friends with George W. Bush. She shares that she's friends with a lot of people who don't necessarily have the same beliefs as she does, and she believes in being kind to everyone. She's kind of surprised by the criticism. Bush's chief of staff said he appreciated the comedian's comments and that for he and former First Lady Laura Bush, well, they respect her and respect people. He's a friendly guy. I think he would be a hoot to sit next to, actually.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and you got to remember, you also have to remember the relationship that George W. Bush has with Michelle Obama and the famous passing of the cough drop.
Yes.
And, you know, just seeing that camaraderie between
those two. Sitting next to him because she just wanted some candy.
Exactly.
Are you surprised or troubled by the criticism? I was astonished.
I'm very surprised by it, and I am also very troubled by it, but I'm even more enheartened by the fact that Ellen addressed it on her show. She said, look, we're friends. I mean, I don't know what the big deal is.
We may not agree on everything, but we can still be friends.
Yeah, I agree.
Believe it or not, Alex does not agree with everything that I...
No. He acts
hard to believe. You know, your judgment is not always, you know.
Well, based on who I work with, I guess you're right about that.
I'm very upset about this, to be honest, because why didn't they dance? I mean, it was Ellen. She's supposed to dance. Why didn't they dance?
Well, the football game.
That really would have broken the internet.
Ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. Hands down. I mean.
All right. Thank you, guys. Good to see you. Kevin, again, congratulations.
I'm going to go take a nap.
Yeah.
Take a nap, please.
Remember.